maybe it's just a Bostonian thing, but I was really genuinely just pissed off that someone would ruin such a, what is such a celebratory day and a historical moment with that kind of action.
You were angry.
So I was angry. I was really pissed off that that someone would do this. It's like, it was a personal attack to my city.
Shalane Flanagan has been running in her city since she was a teenager. She grew up in Marblehead, a nearby suburb, and though she lives in Portland, Oregon now, she frequently returns to Boston to train along the marathon route.
It's my ultimate dream and goal to win the Boston Marathon. I am all in with this training. I have been out on the course training on it multiple times this fall, and I know almost every divot and bump in the road.
The Boston Marathon has been a part of Shalane Flanagan's life since she was a child. Both her parents were marathon runners. Her father ran 11 minutes off world record pace at the Boston Marathon in 1980. Her mother set a women's world marathon record in 1971.
I thought everyone's parents ran. I thought everyone got up and went to the, you know, Sunday long run.
You thought everybody's parents
ran?
Yeah,
I thought it was like Church of Sunday long run. Everyone,
Church
you know,
of Sunday long run.
That's what my dad would call it.
Long before she ever thought of running the Boston Marathon, Shalane used to stand near the finish line of the race to cheer her father on.
I watched from Hereford all the way down to the finish, and that's exactly the two areas where the bombs went off. So it was a surreal moment to think of. That was, I was a little kid watching my dad run right there. I mean, that easily could have been me or my sister.